Hello everyone, this is Revolution once again, and welcome back to the second part of the pre-E3 2019 discussion, because this year I decided I'm only doing two videos instead of four like last year, because I'm not trying to kill myself. So today I have with me Chibi Keith, Cyborg Jiro, and Electric. So you guys introduce yourselves in that order.
Greetings internet, this is Chibi Keith here. I'm alive, if you are aware. Still exist. My channel.
Well, I am Cyborg Jiro. I don't really make content, but I'm here, so. Yep.
Hey, I'm Eldrick, and that's it for now, so, yeah.
Alright, well, everyone is here.
Cue the Smash music. Alrighty. Well, without wasting any more time, let's go ahead and get to the first topic for today. And this is something that is not denied nor confirmed, but there is some evidence leading that it might come true, which is Banjo Threeie, or Banjo-Kazooie 3, whichever one you feel is more easier to say.
Banjo 3 sounds, I understand the way they word it because it's like 2E, but just yeah. 3, but Banjo-Kazooie 3 is fine.
Yeah.
The game we never got.
Okay, so the reason that I feel like Banjo 3E might actually be a thing is because of something that has been going on in terms of, like, Banjo merchandise. So one thing I want to bring up is that there is now a Banjo plush that I've seen at work that we never had before. And there's also these little Totaku figures, like, the little ones that they also made once for, like, Crash and Lara Croft and these other different characters. There's also first four figures, you know, the company that makes these really expensive statues. There are hundreds of dollars and all that jazz. And they made one for Banjo and Kazooie, which looks really nice, but I can't afford that. And then there's also, I'm trying to think of what it's called. It's like the figures that hold things and charge them, made by the Cable Guy company. But not an actual Cable Guy company, because it's not that kind of thing. So they also made one for Banjo that's going to be coming out sometime this year. And it's just like more that I see of this new Banjo merch that these other rare IPs are not getting is strange to me. It also is interesting because I don't know about the first four figures designed, but I know the one for the Totaku and the Cable Guy charging figure, that part of Banjo's design is a bit different in terms of the backpack. Like, there are some details that aren't in the original design. So that's why it's made people speculate, oh, maybe Banjo-Kazooie 3 might be a thing, or it could be that plus Banjo getting in Smash, but the latter is a topic that I've already discussed in the last discussion. So, I'm gonna go ahead and hand off the whole Banjo topic to you three. Dorian, how about you go first?
I wouldn't be surprised, especially since Microsoft has their whole initiative to push more original games from their studios and their acquisition of many video game studios. I feel like it's very likely that they will announce Banjo-Kazooie, because, I mean, a lot of people have nostalgia for it, and it just seems like a game that would sell on the Xbox.
Okay, but here is one question. Do you think it'd actually be developed by Rare, or one of the developers that Microsoft has acquired?
I feel like Rare is going to overlook it, like Killer Instinct.
Mm-hmm.
They'll just overlook it, but I think another developer will do it.
You think there's a good chance Playtonic Games could actually take the hold of the Banjo IP, maybe?
I mean, I don't know if Microsoft would make a deal with them for that.
Microsoft might buy them. They did make a similar game.
That's true. I mean, most of the people for Playtonic were part of the dev team for the original Banjo games, so it's quite possible, but I don't know. I think it's still up to debate for that one. So, Dorian, anything else you have to say before I hand it off to the other two, or...?
No, not really. I hope it looks good, honestly. I hope it's decent. It's,
you know, as long as it doesn't have the, nuts and bolts art style, we don't need blocky... We don't need a blocky Banjo.
I personally didn't mind their designs that much. The game itself, that's a different story.
Yeah.
So, Joe, do you want to go ahead and talk about Banjo 3 real quick?
To be honest, back when Nuts and Bolts came out, I did kind of like it, but I didn't... It still wasn't a, like, Banjo, like, game.
No, it's not.
But...
It's like, I heard it was a decent game, just not a good Banjo game.
Yeah.
The thing that excites me is the fact that Microsoft has been trying to put games on PC, and if Banjo 3 comes out, I'll be able to play it. So
yeah, because they actually did announce Game Pass for PC a few days ago. So that's a thing.
I think they also mentioned trying to put some of their games on other PC platforms like Steam. So
yeah, because I know Halo is actually going to Steam.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna buy that.
Yeah, they're starting off with Reach and then going down the timeline. But anyways, back to Banjo. Keith, anything you have to say?
Yes. I guess I can talk my personal thoughts. I played the original Banjo-Kazooie. I like it a lot better than Mario 64.
The bold words.
I'm throwing that out there. But by the time of this recording, I've still not completed Tui, but I've played a good chunk to say I really like it. It is a very good sequel. I have never played Nuts and Bolts, but after seeing gameplay and a lot of people doing videos on it, I can see that's not Banjo. But other than that, I feel, as Darian was discussing, Banjo is a very likely good chance to come to E3. It's probably because I think the hype of Mario Odyssey and ahead of time, people, we still care about 3D platformers. People love this stuff. So I feel like having that spark is going to probably bring Banjo back. This is my personal prediction.
Alrighty. So one thing I want to bring up is that we've already talked about it being, you know, on Xbox, and then PC is most likely to follow like every other Microsoft game that's come out over the past 3 years. But do you think Microsoft would be okay with releasing it on Switch? Because we already have Cuphead, and there's been a rating. Thank you for Cuphead, even though I'm still going to wait for that physical release later this year. But and there's already been a rating for Ori and the Blind Forest on Switch, and I assume that's going to be announced at E3. So do you think if Banjo 3E is going to be announced at E3, will it also be on Switch?
I really hope so.
I don't think so.
I really wouldn't mind replaying the original game on Switch, because it was just such an hassle to play with the N64.
I would...
And having it would be very nice.
I would say yes, just because nobody really sees Nintendo as a like competition to them, and I think Xbox is trying to get their games on more platforms anyways, so yeah.
Yeah. I mean, with their xCloud, with the streaming service, it's going to be able to stream on phones with their games, which I honestly don't know how that's going to go, but
going to specify on that, saying that I think it's going to be streamable, but not native on the Switch.
With Banjo, I think they'd probably be okay with doing native on the system, but if you talk about something like Halo 5, if they decide to do that with streaming on Switch, then no, I don't see that being native.
I'm just like mostly talking about the graphical fidelity, because I'm sure they want Banjo 3 to look as best they can, because I'm sure that's going to be one of their biggest games of the year.
Yeah, I mean, you can look at...
I don't know how well it'll run on the Switch, though. That's the thing.
I mean, you can look at something like the Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy, where Activision, they got to work on Switch, though they had to do a bit of a downgrade, but it still looked good and was still playable. So I think it would just be the same issue with Banjo. It could easily be resolved that way.
I mean, they got Doom.
I feel like the best optimal way is maybe port the Xbox Live Arcade version, maybe?
Yeah, the first two.
Because, And Nuts and Bolts, but that's already Xbox anyway, and do really people want to have
nuts? I don't think so. Unless for the very small minority. I mean, very small.
Yeah, but there are some fans of that game. So
somehow.
I'm sure. Yep.
Alrighty. So, aside from Banjo just actually getting a proper sequel, just make it good. Don't have to do anything special. Just make it a true-to-form Banjo game, and you're set. Don't try anything stupid. Just give the people what they want. That's all we ask.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, so I think that's pretty much enough for a topic on Banjo. So, next one, and this is probably going to be the topic that has the longest time. Of course, it's Animal Crossing, and I know that Dorian and I aren't the biggest fans of that franchise. It's mostly Joe and Keith, so which one of you want to take the reins first?
Joe, you can go first, I guess. Okay.
Well, unless Nintendo goes back on their word, Animal Crossing is supposed to come out this year.
We haven't heard any announcements since that September Direct, that's true. So...
They haven't had a trailer. No title or anything, but it's literally been 7 years. If they wait another year, it's been 8 years, which is a lot for Animal Crossing.
Do we count the spin-offs, the 3 spin-offs?
I don't count them, but if you want to count them, I guess it's only been maybe 3 years.
Can we especially count Amiibo Festival?
10 out of 10 game.
Good game in someone's eyes.
There are people that like that game, just not a lot.
I don't understand how.
It's just like, if it was like $20, I would think most people would like it.
Well, right now it's only available for like $2.99 used.
Oh. Yeah, and it's probably more expensive if you actually have the Isabel Amiibo.
Like,
if
you
just
have
the game itself, it's
the Amiibos and it's super cheap, I can understand liking it.
Yeah. But just think, all those Amiibo you have to do to actually get the most out of that game is a little
silly. I already have a bunch of Animal Crossing Amiibo.
Wow.
I know you have a bunch of the cards
Amiibo,
as well.
Amiibo cards too?
I do have a card book for them, yes.
Wow.
Animal Crossing Superfan.
Hey, I haven't bought anything new for a while, though. Actually, that reminds me, I wonder if they're going to continue to have Amiibo support, seeing as Amiibo's kind of been dying.
I mean, they're not dying.
Specifically for Animal Crossing?
That's true.
Yeah, I think so.
Because I haven't really seen any big Amiibo support ever since the launch of the Switch, and really, they have like a few as a bonus now, but they're not really
they're not
used
pushing
for a lot
anymore.
Of content anymore. Because I think they did that a lot for the 3DS and Wii U era, and not as big as the Switch, so...
Yeah, because I always feel like retailers are complaining that there's just a lot of stock and no one's really buying, so they're kind of holding back now.
Yeah.
I mean, like, at my store that I work at, we have... Actually, the Amiibo that we have is just some Animal Crossing ones and one Greninja. That's it. That's all we have there. We did have a Young Link, but that was put on pre-order, and it's been over a month since that release, so I just bought it because that guy was never going to pick it up. And I am happy I waited, because now Young Link is mine.
I would like a Young
Link. The last Amiibo I bought was in GameStop.
Oh, they're going to finish the Smash ones, for sure.
Yeah.
I think that's like the last big thing they're going to do. Finish the Smash set, and they're done.
If I'm going to buy another Amiibo, it's probably going to be my best girl, Isabel, but, you know.
There's like two or... There's going to be, what, 3 versions of Isabel Amiibo now?
We have the Fall Isabel, we have Smash Isabel, and then what was the other Isabel?
I think there's another... like Isabel from Animal Crossing, like 2 outfits.
I think so. You may be right about that.
Okay, then it must be her spring summer outfit and then her fall winter outfit and then Smash Isabel.
Another big thing about this game is the fact that there's no street pass, and there are a lot of Animal Crossing features connected to that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So what do you think they're going to do as a replacement? Because every single Animal Crossing, for the most part, has their own quirk. Like, the one on Wii had the Wii Speak channel, which I'm not even going to get into that. But, I'll let you guys get to ideas and opinions since you're more so the experts on the topic.
I think one idea is that they might use the Nintendo app and kind of street pass with that, maybe.
That could work.
That, or they just need to add a lot more online features to this new one.
Yeah.
What kind of thing features, I guess, would you want to see that they do with the app then? Like, special exclusive furniture, I guess?
Maybe that. Maybe an online, like, shopping marketplace to sell your stuff to other people. Maybe for clothing, you could sell your designs there.
That could be neat.
But what if they did all of that activity through the Pocket Camp app instead?
How would they do it with Pocket Camp?
Like, I don't know, they said that Pocket Camp would have some functionality with the new Animal Crossing, but they didn't say how.
I would kind of like that. It would actually give you an excuse to actually play Pocket Camp, since that direct I dropped Animal Crossing. But I was only level 114, I think, so not only that big deal.
It really depends what they do with the app.
If it gets me to play it again, then that's fine. And if it works pretty well together, then that's also good, because that was pretty much the closest thing I got to as a new main Animal Crossing game, even though it's on a smartphone.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I could use that instead of the Nintendo app.
Yeah.
All I know is this Animal Crossing game is gonna have to last at least until the end of the Switch's life cycle, so they need to make sure it's good.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they did a good job with the updates for New Leaf, so...
Yeah. Yeah, it's true. They could add, like, DLC or something down the line to keep it alive.
They will.
Yeah. I don't think they'll have amiibo support, though. I'm just saying. They did a lot for that for New Leaf, though, but if they're declining amiibo support, like we said, it might not come. Though everything will be just there. That's it. I don't think it'll be a problem. Maybe you just use amiibo as, like, a little bonus.
I feel like they might still let you use them to get people to your town, but I guess it really depends on how different the new Animal Crossing game is.
That's what I'm saying. Something like that, but nothing too...
Yeah.
Like, hidden, you can't get to without the amiibo. They're not... I don't think they've really done that. Stopped doing that for a while, so...
I don't think I have anything else to really talk about. I just want control, like, more control, like, with making pathing in the town and, like, more mayor options. That's really what I want.
You might not even be a mayor in this one. I don't know. You could be something.
Do you really think they're gonna, like, stop giving you all that control over your city? Would they go back on that?
Probably.
I mean, what if you're not the mayor? What if you're, like, the governor?
Oh gosh.
The governor of an island.
Politics and Animal Crossing are not mixed.
I mean, you decide who stayed and who left for towns, so.
I like to bring up the fact that Animal Crossing is probably my most played Switch game by the time it comes out, and I have no shame in that. I'm going to clock in many hours, and I do not care.
I want them to let you turn the mayor's office into a community center where you can design it and villagers come in. That'd be cool.
I just hope Isabel's still your secretary.
Yeah.
So, what if she isn't?
She's gonna have to be in the game, because, like, everyone loves Isabel.
Unless she's too busy smashing right now, because when I saw that trailer, Tom looks like, oh, she's busy. I'll take over.
Yeah, so what if Tom Nook is the mayor and he raises taxes for the entire town?
Oh no. Wait, taxes?
Wow.
Yeah, he goes from real estate to being the mayor and raising everyone's taxes just to get more money.
Has it changed at all, I see.
Well, he's the one bringing us the game, so I can't be too mad.
Yep, he's the one that made me happy when I realized we were getting one. I think that's all I've had to say, really, I guess. If Joe got any
I think I'm good.
Yeah.
Alrighty then. That was actually shorter than I thought it would be.
Yeah.
So. Okay, so on topic number 3, and this one it might also be a long one, it depends on what we have to say about it. But it is Pokémon Sword and Shield. Since Keith and Joe took the reins for the last part of starting it off, Dorian, how about you do this one?
Ooh, I don't know if I'm super excited because I feel like Game Freak's gonna play it really safe. Because clearly from how they showed off already the game, it just looks like an upgraded 3DS game. So I'm not super excited about anything new they're gonna do, but I hope they bring something new to the table. After all, there's gonna be a direct this week.
So yeah, this coming Wednesday.
Yeah, so
9 a.m.
Hopefully my opinions
Eastern,
change.
So
6 a.m. over here. I don't know if I'm gonna wake up.
No, that's what happens when you live on the West Coast. You have the worst times for directs.
Unless they're late, then they're good times.
Well, it depends on how late. Because for me, any time is good.
That's true. But I don't know. There was a leak for the Pokemon, apparently. And there's going to be some evolutions of past ones, which I'm always excited for.
Yeah, because we haven't really looked too many. Let's see. I'm not counting X and Y because the only one we got was just Sylveon. But ones that actually had new evolutions, whether it be progressing or like baby forms, was Gen 4 with Sinnoh. So it's been years, over a decade actually, since we've had anything like that in Generations.
I'm pretty excited about that. That's probably actually one of my favorite portions, seeing past Pokemon and their new evolutions.
Mm-hmm.
I knew Omega kind of took over that for a little bit. That's why they didn't do it, because of Mega Evolutions. I mean, they're cool, but it's not the same, because it's only temporary.
Yeah.
Speaking but other of which... than that, I don't know. Uh-huh.
Oh, sorry, continue.
Oh, no, I was going to say, the only thing I can really see for them to change is, the online features. I hope that's good. I want to actually, do stuff other than just battling. I don't know, make it more interesting, the online, because you just battle someone once, okay, we're done. Yeah. Never going to see you again.
Yeah, the online for Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee is the worst that I've seen for Pokemon. It's like they weren't trying, because you couldn't, battle or trade with randoms. You had to have a specific input code to connect to someone. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure it was just a Let's Go thing, because there was more 100%. So,
it was more.
Yeah, it was more of a casual game than main
Pokemon.
Yeah. So I think for this actual game, they'll do it the way that they did in X and Y and Sun and Moon. Though I would really like the player pass system or whatever that was called, that was on the bottom screen, X and Y and
mm-hmm.
Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, because they ruined that with the that plaza and Sun and Moon. That was,
I have no idea how they ruined
why
that.
Why did they do that? They had such a good system for Gen 6 and then Gen 7. It was just how?
No.
You
Hello.
Made it worse. It was good. It was
There's
good.
No bottom screen anymore.
Walk through the plaza.
No, but you can still
Someone
have
says, I love
press minus and have a list pop up like that.
Yeah. I think the biggest thing they need to do is have really good writing and not I don't know. I guess just not have bad Pokemon designs.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's always gonna be bad designs in every single generation. You can't have all winners.
I'm not too worried about designs, honestly.
Yeah.
I just hope the region is fun to explore. I hope there's good post game, because post games for 3DS games has been kind of
The only one that was kind of decent was, well, I shouldn't say the only one, because there was Oris, which had the Delta episode, but that still to me does not replace the Battle Frontier from Emerald. I'm still salty about that to this day. And as for Sun and Moon didn't have a good one. Ultra Sun and Moon, I never finished. I got bored of it quite quickly. Though I did like the idea of fighting every single boss character from every gen from the evil teams. Never got around to it because I only went through... That was what?
That was the Ultra only, right?
Yeah, only an Ultra.
Yeah, because I haven't played Ultra.
Yeah, so, I only played the first hour of it. I dropped it because I got so bored.
See,
no, don't blame me. That tutorial is garbage. Another thing, I hope the tutorial for the new one is not as bad as Sun and Moon.
Or it lets you skip
terrible.
It.
Yeah, anything. Because, oof. Can never make a game slower. Yeah, okay. Exactly.
Like, I beat Moon, but then I bought Ultra Sun, and it was mostly the same, and I kind of lost interest.
Yeah. It's... They just need to fix the pacing and just give us more content that will let us have fun. Yeah. Not have it stagnate.
Make the region interesting. I don't know. The island theme for Sun and Moon was interesting, but it felt small. I didn't feel like I was exploring, really. Yeah. It just kind of felt like tourist destination. It's like, oh, stop here. Go here. I didn't feel like I was exploring a region.
It was because nothing was connected.
It was not fun.
It was all separate. Yeah.
No, but I mean, islands don't necessarily have to be connected, because my favorite one being in Gen 4, the island, I forgot, post-game island.
Oh, it was,
That one was fun.
Yeah. I can't remember what it was called, but I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, there's different ecosystems, felt varied, whereas in each island, it's just one single ecosystem, and it kind of feels like, well, alright.
Yeah, like, one thing I would have liked for them to do is, instead of, using a boat to go to each island, let us swim.
Yeah,
like, you surf to each island. Honestly. That would have been so much more interesting. I mean, I know people could complain about Hoenn, 7.6, too much water, but I liked exploring Hoenn's water. I like exploring the waterways and the different ocean areas.
And they always had, islands and whatnot for you to explore. Like, for example, in Gen 1, Cinnabar Island, even then.
Mm-hmm.
They always have, little things that you can explore. It makes it more interesting and makes the world feel alive.
And even in Fire and Leaf Green, you had the Sevii Islands. Like, even though they were separate, they felt very unique. I never got that same feeling with Sun and Moon.
I think there's going to be a lot less water in this one, because it's, England.
Yeah.
And it's going to rain all the time, right?
I guess it's supposed to rain.
I hope so. That would actually be kind of fun to look at. Hopefully they make the rain graphics look interesting.
Mm-hmm. Like, have it go against the screen. But not have it look cheap.
I hope they have, an extra island being Ireland. I just hope they add extra stuff.
Because,
they've
shown
exploring.
The map, and Ireland's not there unless, you can take a boat and go to Ireland. That'd be great.
Fantastic. That's all I asked for. I just want to explore. That's my favorite part of Pokemon, and the past few games have been kind of lackluster in that.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, there is in X and Y, there is a train that is I can't remember which city it's in because it's been years since I played X and Y, but it connected to something, but you can never actually go to where it says it was connected to. So there was something I actually found out a few months ago that apparently there is a underground railway train system that goes from France to England in real life. That would be amazing if you could visit Kalos in the post game. It's probably not going to happen, but I would love for it to.
No, that would be cool, but...
Or just one of the other regions would be pretty cool.
Yeah, but the reason I say Kalos because that's the closest one.
Yeah.
Because unless they want to, use an airplane and have us go to Unova, because there is an airport in the Unova region. That'd be the only other good option. That would make sense.
That'd be hype. If you can go to New York.
Ooh. Yep.
Region jumping again. They haven't done something like that since Gen 2.
Yeah.
No. So.
Add DLC regions.
Yeah, easy money, honestly.
Yeah.
What's right? It called? Pokemon. Which version? No. Pokemon.
But there's one thing I wanted to address, which was a rumor slash speculation type deal, is that you know how with X and Y there are the Mega Evolutions, and Gen 7 there was the Z moves, where the past two Pokemon generations have had their specific gimmick. Apparently, what people are saying for this one is that some Pokemon will get armored forms, and the reason that people are talking about speculation with these rumors is that in the remake for the Mewtwo movie, Mewtwo does not have the same armor that he did in the original anime film. Instead, it's completely new design, so people are thinking that that design will be the armored form that Mewtwo will use in this game, and that other Pokemon will follow suit. But, as I said, just speculation, rumor, could be true, could be not. I just don't know how I'd feel about it if they went along with that idea.
But maybe just to switch some Pokemons from being a defensive to... No, from attack, very offensive type of Pokemon to a very defensive one. That's the only thing I can really think of for, like, justification for that.
Or it could be, like, it could boost certain... I wouldn't say stats, because that's mostly what Mega Evolution is. But if, like, it could boost the effect of the ability that they have. Because we don't have anything that... I wouldn't say Mega Evolution 2, because as for their abilities, say, for instance, what is it? Blaze for, like, the fire-type starters. It would do double as much stat boosting with Blaze whenever you're in, like, low health. Like, more than usual.
Yeah.
But just an idea, but I don't know what purpose these armored forms could be used for if this stuff doesn't end up becoming true. So I have nothing to say beyond that.
Speaking of starter types, do we guys know which starter we'll choose?
I don't know. I'm trying to choose between Scorbunny and Grookey, because I do not like Sobble. He kind of annoys me, but he's not bad, but he's just... I usually try to wait until after the middle and final forms of evolutions for the starters are shown, and then I decide.
Yeah.
But I'm just not impressed with Sobble.
I'm probably going to be Scorbunny, at least for now, but like with the last generation, I liked Litten, but then I hated like his other two forms, so I guess we'll see.
Turrican and Cineroar, and now he's in Smash. Somehow.
He's so bad.
That's awful. I mean, he has some neat gimmicks that can help him in Smash, but...
Yeah, but his recovery is so bad.
Yeah, like, if you can't recover after using the side B and then the up B, then you're pretty much screwed.
But this is Pokemon, not Smash.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Let's go back
to
no, it's Pokken,
choice.
My bad.
Yeah.
It's Pokken.
Yeah, Pokken.
So, Keith and Dory, you two still need to name your starter.
I'm just waiting for the finals. That's it.
Okay, well, which one interests you the most just by design alone?
I kind of don't like him all too much, to be honest.
I understand.
I've grown warmer towards him, but... I mean, I'm still skeptical. Well, not skeptical, just unsure what to pick.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Okay, as for me, I think I'm going to go with Scorbunny. It's going to be weird, because I haven't really chose a fire-type starter since Black and White, so I'm used to choosing usually grass or really water, but this will be interesting.
I gotcha. I think the last fire starter I chose was... Yeah, Gen 3. So, haven't chosen one since Torchic. Well, like, for a main team, I should say. Because I did use, like, a few of them every now and then. But as for the one I stick with, it's just been Torchic. It's the only one. Okay, so anything else we have to say about Pokemon before we move on to topic number 4?
I guess that's just a little thing. Let's Go didn't really appeal to me, so I skipped it. But this game, I think, is... gonna be worth my money.
Yeah, I understand. I mean, I streamed the entirety of Let's Go Eevee. The game was fun to an extent. It had some nostalgia pandering, actually more nostalgia pandering than I should have done. And I just didn't enjoy it as much. Like, it's not a bad game, but it's, in terms of, like, Pokemon games that play, like, Pokemon games, like, the mainline ones, that's probably my least favorite of them all.
Yes, but I understand why they did it. They wanted to capture the Go audience so they could get them more into the mainstream.
Yeah, and I also feel like it was just them wanting to get a Pokemon game on the Switch that played like traditional Pokemon, but also played a little bit with Go, and they just wanted to capture some main audience, and also Kanto because nostalgia. So, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, looking at Let's Go Now, I was like, this game looks fine, but then seeing the Sword and Shield trailer and seeing the comparisons between the models and just how it looks, it's like, whoa. This is the real deal right now. This is, I thought it was going to be something similar to how Let's Go looked, but I'm very, very glad that isn't the case.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess that's all I have to say there.
I think with your comment about the armor forms, from like how everything is designed in this game, it looks like there's a lot of nature versus technology in all of the areas, so that might have some credence to it.
Nature versus technology. I didn't know we were talking about part of three.
I'm just saying. Like,
yeah, just... and like with the
I see what you're saying.
And like with the armored forms, it also, it would somewhat take inspiration from, like, you know, medieval times with knights, with Arthur and the Round Table.
And Sword and Shield. So.
Yeah, Sword and Shield. So it would make sense if they did have armored forms, so it's not out of the question. So.
But I think that's all I have.
Alrighty. Well, in that case, let's move on to the next topic, which is Luigi's Mansion 3. Keith.
Bayonetta 3?
No, not Bayonetta. So, Keith, since I know that you're a big Luigi's Mansion fan, do you want to take it first?
Yeah, I guess. To be honest, I kind of forgot Luigi's Mansion 3 was a thing, because Animal Crossing is trending more than... But, as similar to how Animal Crossing, we have not seen any follow-up since that September Direct again. I'm hoping the game will be coming out maybe in a mid-October release, or maybe late September. Probably, I think that would be the best place to put it.
I'd say September.
Somewhere around late September, maybe mid-October.
Yeah.
I'm fine with either, because my birthday's around that time, so... But, as for I'm really excited, I feel like this is the game I've been wanting since the original Luigi's Mansion. The true sequel, I guess. I know it's not... really two, but in my eyes, I think I would call it Luigi's Mansion 2.
Like, to me, I believe it is being developed by Next Level Games, and they did the remake for the original Luigi's Mansion on 3DS, so...
I love that remake.
So they know what they're doing, just will they go with the format of the original game, or with the mission-based setup of Dark Moon?
I feel like they're going to take the setup of the Poltergeist gameplay of Dark Moon and combine it with the open world setup of the original game, maybe. Mm-hmm. I think those blend together pretty well.
Yeah, because if you see, there's, at least not from what we know, there's not a bunch of different mansions. It's like one giant tower that, let's be honest, we'll just call it Hotel Mario.
Aha, here's the problem.
I was wondering if, you know, Luigi will have to rescue Mario again, or if Mario is absent this time, and Daisy, or if it's Luigi something debut. Completely separate from the rest of the Mario characters, aside from Egad and King Boo.
I wouldn't mind that again. It's something, it's just that I like seeing Luigi getting his time to shine, mm-hmm. really. Because saving Mario, you see, after all the shenanigans he puts up with his brother, really, he kind of gets... that moment, I did it, but
I do it.
Yep, I do it. King Boo, is gonna come back. He has to come back.
But will he be the main antagonist?
More than likely, but I wouldn't mind if there was a different antagonist.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know who they could throw off who wants to.
They could always make a new one.
Yep. We need more original Mario characters now that I think about it. All the time. But that's a whole different topic for a whole different day.
Toadsworth is the villain.
Who's the villain?
Toadsworth.
Boozworth.
No, Toadsworth.
But you said Boozworth.
Oh, Boozworth as... Oh, no. No, Toadsworth. Toadsworth.
You're crossing... Did Boo just blend in? Oh, no. I don't want to ever have a Bowsette thing again.
No,
please.
Never.
No.
I mean, they already made a Booette. Like...
I know. And I've seen the one where they take the crown and throw it off, throw it in the lava. And they're like, oh, no, the lava's lava head or something. I'm like, oh, gosh, no. Can't escape. That crown needs to die. And the worst part, this is kind of going off topic, the worst part, they had the description in Luigi U where it said, sorry, Luigi, you can't wear it. Only Toadette can. Luigi. Why? But anyway. I guess one thing I wanted to bring up, how did you, may I ask you, guys, have you played Dark Moon?
Yes, I did.
Okay. What did you think of Scarescraper, if you ever tried that?
I played it, but I don't think I ever played it with someone else. I think I only played it solo.
It's really hard to get people for that, which I understand. The online isn't that bad, though. I kind
of
like it.
Speaking of which, I think this is probably where you're going, but you're talking about having a similar mode in 3.
That's what I'm getting at.
I'll let you continue on.
Okay. It's like, I think the Scarescraper was fine. I feel like I'm pretty sure if they want people to really, instead of using the D-pad to communicate, they could have, they'll probably integrate voice chat in their app, probably. Which I really sure it's gonna happen. It's not the way we want it, but
just stick with
their
Discord.
Idea. Yeah, but and then maybe have some special modes, I guess. That wouldn't really be like affect you on your single player campaign, I guess. Mm-hmm. Kinda like how Dark Moon did it. But it's just still a fun little distraction after you beat the story. And I guess also wanted to bring up, you think co-op could be an optimal thing in the single player?
I mean, I think they would be able to get it work fine, maybe, with just a single Joy-Con.
Yeah, it's just I don't know how they would integrate that, because if they do something like similar to how some Mario games do it, where you're just like Cappy, or you're just a cursor, just something, mm-hmm. not really to Luigi's, so... I mean, I think they experimented that with the remake of Luigi's Mansion, where you could have a co-op with the Gooigi. I never tried that myself, but it still looked cool.
Yeah, I never picked up the 3DS port, so I didn't get to try it out.
Yeah. I didn't have friends to play it with, because 3DS was kind of dying at that point.
Yeah.
But I enjoyed that remake a lot, just as much as I did with the original.
Mm-hmm.
What if EatGad has like a protege that he can play as player 2 if you do co-op?
How about we just have EatGad as a playable character?
Yeah, I prefer that over a Gooigi or the different colored ones from Dark Moon.
Yeah, and having like special maybe dialogue he'll share. I don't know, that'd be cool. Instead of just him just calling you from his Game Boy player or whatever all the time. But he's old, so I guess it's why he can't be playable.
I mean, that didn't stop him from collecting ghosts in Luigi's Mansion 1.
Until we saw Luigi, he's like, oh, I found someone that could do all my work.
Yeah.
I never have to see ghosts ever again. Oh, man.
But yeah, I think having EGAD playable would be fantastic. I would love it.
Oh, absolutely. But I guess going... as I continue on, I hope they do just one giant mansion just to explore, because that's what I thought that was the only thing that Dark Moon kind of was lacking,
mm-hmm.
but I understand because it's a handheld. The mission structure works for a handheld. It's just having those multiple mansions there kind of got burned out just to go to a next mission and stuff. I finished it all the way through. I enjoyed the ending is probably one of my favorite endings in Mario game history. say, Luigi series history. But I'm hoping they can make another ending that kind of makes me have the feels, I guess.
Yeah.
But I don't know if nothing will top Darkman or even the original Luigi's Mansion ending. So. Mm-hmm.
So, let me think. In terms of... I already lost my train of thought. I don't know what I was going to say. Oh, crap. someone else talk while I try, I think.
Oh, well, as for Luigi's Mansion, I actually want the atmosphere to match the first game.
Okay.
Because I prefer the atmosphere of the first game a lot. It's not meant to be, like, scary. It's different. But it is more, like, it's uneasy. It's not scary. It's just different. A little uneasy. It definitely is.
The atmosphere in Luigi's Mansion is pretty unique. I'll give you that, especially with the eerie atmosphere. You hear him humming, you hear like the sounds, just like hear that, see that intense breathing whenever it's in a dark room.
Mm-hmm. Oh, to yeah. see that the HD fog. Well, not fog, but that HD breath of his, just with the cold, icy rooms.
Yep.
And you can almost taste the breath.
Hey, we're not into Joy-Con HD rumbles, not that far.
Wow, I think I found out my next topic.
Oh, actually, no, I just thought of something. Some integration that I think they could do, whether it be from launch or a later update, is Luigi's Mansion 3 VR Labo mode.
Oh, yeah. That's
I mean, I have my Labo VR right here. If they put it in, I will try it on VR and give my impressions, because I'd actually be very interested in that, especially considering that there is a Luigi's Mansion VR arcade machine. That is based off of 2.
I have played that. It is amazing.
Yeah, I would really want to play it, but isn't it only at like a Dave & Buster's in the US?
We didn't have it at a Dave & Buster's. It was a different. It was just one at the mall I visited. I was telling you about probably earlier. But it's nice. I beat the whole game in like a sitting. Oh, glorious.
That sounds really fun.
Oh, it was a blast.
Don't you mean it was a suck?
What?
Nothing.
Oh, please.
Anyways, yeah. Any last thoughts on Luigi's Mansion 3? Actually, no. I remember what I was going to say now. With Dark Moon, I didn't mind having the multiple mansions, but the mission system did kind of annoy me. Because, you know, you finish a mission, have to go through the same area of a certain mansion, and it just got really annoying. Even though I still enjoy the game a lot, but that was one thing that bugged me. And then whenever I look at the new area that you have to explore, it just reminds me of Tartarus from Persona 3. So there's that. Just waiting for Nyx to be at the top. Just waiting for the fall to kill everyone. Everyone clamoring for death. Yeah, but anyways, I think we're pretty much done with Luigi's Mansion 3 as a topic, and the last topic is pretty much one to two things of, like, games, what have you, that we want to see from E3 that we already know about, or that we don't even know exist yet. So, who wants to take the reign first?
There's actually a few that I kind of remembered in the past few days that
Okay, then
exist.
I'll let you go first.
One being the Harry Potter RPG. I don't know what happened.
Oh, that was
that.
A thing?
Are they going to show it E3?
Huh? I didn't know that was
that
a thing.
Fake?
Was it fake? I don't know.
Was that fake?
I didn't know it existed.
Oh, no, that was the thing. They leaked, there was like some leaked footage, which I'm assuming was for the investors.
Oh, I remember now. Yeah, that was a thing. So maybe they could show it off this year.
Yeah, maybe it actually is a thing. I don't know. Another one being with the Metal Gear Solid voice actors saying that they have a big project they're working on. Maybe Metal Gear Solid 1 remake? Metal Gear remake? I don't know.
I don't know how I feel about that in the hands of Konami only. I'm afraid they'd, you know, mess it up somehow.
Snake?
Hatsune Miku.
You remember that
one. It's like one of my Japanese animes.
Oh man, my favorite.
Then Otacon just proceeds to wet himself.
Snake, watch out. That's Kirby, also known as.
Let's see what else. Final Fantasy VII Remake, of course.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm looking forward to that. It's been 4 years. I hope it's decent, because they can ruin it.
Yeah, and one thing I'll say is that they've teased Tifa. They haven't actually shown her. I swear if they ruin her design, someone's getting the boot at Square Enix. Because I really like her design.
They've been doing pretty good in design so far.
Yeah, I just don't want them to mess up her design.
Her two very special designs.
Do you guys personally feel that they're still going to make the remake episodic? Or are they going to release the full game?
I don't know.
It's episodic. I think they're still going with that, definitely.
I haven't heard if they were going to continue with the episodic thing.
I don't know how I feel about that, honestly. That's one thing I feel like it's going to be sort of...
I feel like it's going to be sort of like Final Fantasy 13, where each one feels like a complete game.
But you know, if it's like that and has enough content, then I think I'd be okay. But at the same time, I'm still cautious. So, here's hoping.
Yeah, right now it's kind of a everything's open waters. So it's not really sure. I mean, it's Square. We don't know what they're going to do. They have messed up in the past, so... The one thing they get right, though, is definitely aesthetics, so I'm not worried about that.
Yeah. Like, in the trailer, whenever they had the PlayStation thing, it was, you know, play first on PlayStation, so I see it coming to Xbox and PC, but Switch? I don't know. I really don't.
I feel that's very, very unlikely. They would have to downgrade the game a lot if they wanted to make it run on Switch. Really, I don't see it happening.
So, there's going to be Final Fantasy VII Pocket Edition.
Oh no, please yeah. don't. I'd rather just stick with the original.
Pocket Edition. This is coming since I played the original. I like to see how they do stuff in the remake. Maybe fix the text that I didn't understand. What's going on.
Yeah, but, I mean, as long as. I mean, imagine if they had outtakes of the voice actors saying those, you know, mistranslated lines just for fun.
I would like that. I'm here to take the load off your shoulders. He's just as I picked him when I first played the original game. That is the voice I had in my mind.
Okay, is there anything else you wanted to add, Dorian, before we move on to Keith and Joe?
Any other games? I mean...
Well, just like anything of what you've already mentioned.
Oh, anything else I've heard of?
No, I'm talking about like anything that you've already talked about. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, other than that, it's just going to be wishful thinking.
Okay. Okay, so Joe, do you want to go next?
Okay. I'll be quick, but I got three. The first two, don't know when they're... Okay, Viva Pinata is never going to come out, but I want it to.
Okay.
And Pokémon Mystery Dungeon, I really want them to make another one. And aside from that, BioWare has like failed at their last two games, so hopefully they don't screw up Dragon Age, which they've hinted at that they might show.
There's been reports that they're I think they did say they're gonna show it during E3, but there's been reports that we have you know, microtransactions and
Well, there's going to be a multiplayer mode.
That they may be putting some of their modern day political agenda in there, which hope not, because I don't really like it when companies do that. I like to play games to escape.
Yeah, I really hope they don't mess it up too bad, because this might be BioWare's last chance.
Yeah, after their last two blunders. So. Yeah. Anything else you want to say before we move on to Keith, or you're pretty much good?
No, I'm good.
Okay, Keith, your turn.
Okay, well, I guess going back to a little bit of the Final Fantasy, I guess I would like to see some more ports, though. I don't know how they could handle... I feel like 8 could be fine.
Well, here's the thing, they lost the source code for 8.
What? Yeah, that's what I've done research on that, and I'm like, oh, that's why they can't get 8.
I do want to play 8
so bad.
It's on Steam, I think.
Yeah, but every time I buy something, it's on Switch, and it's coming on Switch. Yeah, it's the curse, I'm afraid. Yeah, I keep doing Switch, that.
So.
Buy it on Steam, yeah. So it comes out on Switch.
Yeah, I understand why 15 and only Pocket Edition's on there, because 15 could never run on that.
Mm-hmm. It can't run on my PC. I tried doing the graphics test for it. It was bad.
Well, I don't know. I guess just keep revving up Final Fantasy if you can, even if you have to make spin-offs, maybe on Switch exclusive. Maybe that would be cool.
Yeah.
I mean, excited for Crystal Chronicles, by the way. So,
I mean, if we're talking Final Fantasy, there's been a rumor going around that Square might actually, you know, finally put out a remastered trilogy of the 13 games.
That would be cool. I would like to experience
maybe that. Yeah, whether or not those come to Switch, who knows? Knowing Square, I could see them just putting them on Xbox and PlayStation. I don't know if they'd be willing to put the 13 trilogy on Switch or not. But we'll see.
I guess getting off the topic of Final Fantasy, I wouldn't mind. This is going to be kind of an ambitious thing to say. I like to see some Paper Mario in some shape or form, just to see where they're taking that, particularly.
Yeah.
After seeing, it's just, I don't want to see where they've improved. They made Mario Odyssey. Super Mario Party was a huge improvement of the last Mario Party, so I want to see if they can do the same thing for Paper Mario, if they've understood the complaints from the last two games, and probably they hear
last
us.
Three games, I'd say. I don't know.
Paper Jam is kind of a side thing. I don't really count that.
No, it's a crossover.
Yeah, that's more of a Mario Luigi game with just Paper Mario inside. It's good on paper, ha ha ha, but
wow.
That was probably my least favorite Mario and Luigi game.
Gotcha.
He's just bringing back the original too, or have it like them.
I wouldn't mind replaying the original if they remastered them and made it with probably the new Paper Mario graphics though, because the one thing I liked about Color Splash, it looked amazing.
Yeah.
The game itself, it's alright. It's better than Sticker Star, but it's still not as amazing as...
I think most Mario games, aside from some of the very crappy spin-offs, are better than Sticker Star.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that Sticker Star is better than Mario Party 9 and 10. I'd rather play Sticker Star over those two games.
Alright, I'm not gonna turn you to a meal here, but I won't.
So, anything else you wanted to mention before I name off mine?
I guess I could really... In terms of software, really, this is kind of a thing I wanted to see. Can I have themes for my Switch,
please? Yeah.
Yeah, please. We need that. Definitely.
I mean, I have, like, 10 3DS themes. Why don't I have that for the Switch? I will pay for those.
Yeah, it's been over 2 years, and we still don't have themes for the Switch.
I'm tired of the black and white theme. It's like, you see, there's going to be more themes. What are those themes going to be? I will pay for them. Give me them. But I think that was all I wanted to get out of the way there. Just probably, that's about it.
Well, in the last discussion, I had the same kind of topic, and I named some things, but there are a few things I remembered, so I'm going to add that on to what I mentioned before. So, they already confirmed from what Square Enix did that the DLC for Kingdom Hearts 3 will be shown off, and I'm very curious what they're going to do with that, of how that's going to add to the story, if, you know, it does some of the stuff that wasn't shown during the main game, or if it adds like what they did with Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, where they had the different replayable boss fights against the organization members. I would love to see something like that.
There's DLC for that?
Yeah, for KH3 DLC is confirmed to be shown at E3. It's called Remind is the title that they gave it.
Oh boy, a re.
Yeah, another Remind.
Maybe I will have to play some more Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah, and I'm hoping that they might have, if not two, maybe at least one playable character that isn't Sora. Because I know that Keith hasn't gotten around to it, but there were two playable characters aside from him, but it was very short segments. So
I played, the first I got was the first visit to Traverse Town, so I did get to experience Riku when he was
okay. So you don't know the other the third character that was
no, going there. I won't say it, I do not.
But I hope that character is, you know, playable, or they pick another character that was shown. That was part of the Seven Guardians. Person they've been training? Oh, you mean Kyrie? Kyrie.
Yeah, why can't I
play her? I guess they could have Kyrie playable, or even Axel or Lee or whatever you want to call him. Just have an entire segment of their training and just have a playthrough of that. Because we don't know what they did.
Can I play as Master?
No, Master Yen Sid.
Can I play as Master Yen Sid?
I mean, I guess you could.
I don't want to just a pancake here, but I want to meet him so bad, but it's not mine.
Well, aside from the Kingdom Hearts, you know, DLC, let's see. Of course, there's the Battletoads remake and Halo Infinite, but that's not... those two things aren't something I'm extremely interested in, but I at least want to see what they do in terms of both of those. So the only other thing that I can think of... is a game that's already been announced and we've only had a story trailer for it, is Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. They're just supposed to be doing live streams throughout the week of E3, so of course I'm not gonna wait and watch all their live streams just to see gameplay of Fallen Order, but I'm hoping that for once we can get a good Star Wars game again, because I'm tired of the stuff that EA has been putting out for Star Wars. It's Battlefront 1 and 2, especially the first one, was garbage. Second one, what were they thinking with the DLC at the beginning? I mean, I know they kind of, well, not DLC, but the microtransaction loot box crap that they started with. I mean, at least they got rid of that, but still, why was that a thing in the first place? And even then, the gameplay was kind of subpar.
We already have a good Star Wars game coming out this year, and it's called Star Wars Pinball.
Yeah. Because they said for Fallen Order, it's single player, no microtransactions, fully story, no online needed at all to actually play it. I just want it to be good. That's all I want. Just a good Star Wars game. Just please, EA, I never thought I would beg you for anything, but please, just make a good Star Wars game.
Wow. Hold on. Can you say that again, but this time pay me?
No. Don't make me repeat it. But anyways, I think that's pretty much all I have to say for that final topic, unless there's anything that you guys thought of that you want to mention before we end off the discussion.
Hope this E3's good.
I think we're all in agreement on that.
Yeah.
Alrighty, so with all of that out of the way, I think that's pretty much good for us to finish this discussion. So, this has been Revolution, and I'd like to thank you all for, well, not watching, but listening, because this is more of a podcast than anything. And I'd like to thank you three for joining me. If you want to go in the order that you're listed to kind of say your goodbyes, then we can end it off. So, Keith, you go first.
Alright. Well, once again, I am Shiki, and I hope you enjoyed our little commentary here. Hope my Luigi's Mansion stuff didn't get you too crazy for me, but yeah, I have a channel. I've been pretty lazy though, I'll be honest, so what you see is what you get, I guess, until I feel like it. But for those who watch my stuff, I'm still alive, so just throwing that out there.
I once again, I am Cyborg Giro, and I guess you can follow me on Twitter. I don't really make YouTube videos, at least currently. But I just hope this is a good E3, and yeah, see ya.
Dorian, your turn. Go. Dorian, are you there? I think we lost him.
Oh, you guys could have just kept going.
Well, okay. We already finished our outros. So we were just waiting on you.
Oh, okay. Then, all right. See you guys. Bye.
Wait, you didn't say your name before you did the outro.
Oh, it's Altric. All right. See ya.
Okay, and as I said, thank you guys for watching, and God bless, and I'll see you all next time. Later, everyone.